You want to learn to be happier? For real, I'm serious. You want to learn to be happier? Okay, start with this. First of all, we got to go through the chakras, and don't be weirded out. Chakras are just seven different areas that we need to fulfill in order to be happy, okay? It's not a weird thing. It's not a, another religion type thing. It's just the seven. I mean, there's seven musical notes. There's seven colors of the rainbow. There's a lot of things that are seven, and there's seven areas of our body that we need to fulfill in order to be happy. So let's start, okay? First of all, it's your root chakra, and this is your basic needs. Make sure that you get good food. Seriously, don't torment yourself with nasty, lazy, not good for you food. Give yourself good food. Honor your body. The next chakra, above your basic needs, which, give yourself a good place to live. Make sure it's clean. Respect yourself, guys. I mean, it doesn't, I don't do the OCD thing. That to me is a low vibrating frequent, vibration. So I don't do the OCD thing. I'm cozy, I keep my house tidy, nice, comfortable. You can come over, kick your feet up, put your shoes on top of my coffee table. I don't care, it wipes off. Give yourself a nice, cozy, homey, comfortable place to live. Your next chakra is your hormone chakra. It's your sex, it's your exciting, fun, good times, it's your girl giggles, it's your man cave time, it's your fun time, it's your temporary fun time. Make sure you have really great temporary fun. Go for a walk through the woods. Go for ice cream. Sneak in an arcade and play on a machine every once in a while. Do something for yourself. Do something fun. So do something temporary that's gonna kind of get your hormones off. Make love with somebody you really love. You get the picture. So the next chakra is your power. Okay, you need to feel like you have power over something. You know that not everything has power over you, that you're in control of something, right? There's something you're good at. There's something you've got power over. And I don't know what it is. Maybe it's beating a drum. Maybe it's building a birdhouse. Maybe it's cooking an awesome meal that everybody loves. Maybe it's biking across the entire city because you can, because you have that power. Whatever your power is, make sure you have a power. Find your power. Find something that gives you the feeling of power, and make sure it's a high resonating vibration and not a low one, guys. That goes for the other two chakras as well. Okay, when you're having fun, don't do something that's gonna put you lower. Do something that's gonna put you higher. Your next chakra is your heart chakra, your chakra of love, your chakra of love. So make sure that you love something. It could be an animal, it could be your baby. It could be your grandma. It could be the soup kitchen where you volunteer. It could be your little next door neighbor. The kid is just so adorable. And, the mama's not always able to take them out to go do whatever. Maybe you could take them out to go do whatever. Your love chakra. Make sure that is nice and full. High vibrations. And then the next one right here is your throat chakra. It's the one where you express yourself, not necessarily with your voice, okay? So you need to express yourself. And it might not be talking to someone, or it could be singing, it could be dance. It could be, you could express yourself in a work of art. You could express yourself in so many different areas, but make sure you're expressing yourself so that people can see a little bit into who you are. You've got to have that open. Make sure that it's a high resonating vibration. And your next chakra is up here. Make sure you're thinking, guys. challenge your thoughts, challenge your knowledge, learn. Go into, different areas, like something you've never learned before, something that you want, maybe into an art gallery. You've never learned about art. Maybe you could go in there and ask the person in there, teach me a little bit about what you know about art, learning new musical instrument, learn. Keep that thing working. And then up here, right there, is the power and intelligence of the universe that I call God. Sometimes I call Pi, because power and intelligence, 3.14, it's all of everything. It's the whole shebang. Anyway, that's what's up here. Right there, believe it or not, that power and intelligence, I have no idea what that power looks like, but it's my best friend, so that's possible. It's my best friend, even though I don't believe it is a person, a guy. It's definitely not a man. It's definitely not a man shooting lightning bolts down. It's a vibration. It's a creative vibration. It's a positive, wonderful, spectacular, majestic, divine. It's a perfect vibration. So get a connection with it. Find that vibration up there. Get a relationship with that vibration. You can talk to it as if it's a human. It's not a human, or if it is, I'm whatever, but I don't want to tell God what God is, but God is a power and an intelligent power. And you can communicate with this intelligent power, and it will communicate in a very strange way back.